What is it about your hobby that keeps you coming all the way out here? Is it the freedom? Wandering in search of that perfect spot? You've made your own path through these hills. Tasted the fresh water of our lakes, our rivers. You've been on the water with friends at sunrise and helped the locals long past sunset. But you just keep coming back. At this spot, you got a pretty good idea what's lurking beneath the surface. But there's only one way to find out. Whether it's the one you write home about or the one that gets away, that feeling is what gets you hooked. That whether it's your first time or your 100th time, you never know what you're gonna catch until it's caught. Call of the Wild, the Angler.
You there! Fancy a new rod? They'd be flying off the shelves if I had any. Buy something next time, okay?
The plan is to let these loosestrife dry up and burn them down like hell's teeth. You've still got 3/4 to go, so don't let up. That looks like the last of them bleeding ox eyes. Sally can't wait no longer, but I got time, so see me when you can. Now we know this blister us better than it does. And that Sun Tzu fella was always saying you should know your enemy. Old Sunshine can't obliterate an invader like Clayton can. So come on home. We're going to war, and it won't be pretty.
The park was imagined by Nathaniel V. Johnson as a scenic pleasure park. However, this was met with stern opposition from the locals. it ain't the last leech still sucking my nightmare and yours, the watermelon. This ain't the same kind of corpulent blood guzzler you use for bait, though. This parasite slurps away at the very ground we stand on. Unlike its just as evil twin, the sawmill, this piece of work is allowed to keep working, which makes its work that much worse. I just hope this thing stops spinning before the world does. If I'm around to see it, all the better. Thank you.
Thank you.
those sneaky, swarming, creepy, crawling little tree munchers got something coming to them. And that little something is called Clayton's Wrath. You're halfway done and I'm rip-roaring to go, bud. Here you see the tracks of my tears. One more of man's attempts to siphon away nature's bounty at a heavy cost. This railway here carried a precious cargo out of the park to be refined and sold for coin. However, it got shut down when the powers that be did the right thing for once. After the mining industry was ixnayed here at the park, we had no more need for a choo-choo or two. Now they're gone to join the rest of the metal they hauled out of here. This here is what folks call Ghost Town. Although a few hundred years ago, you'd have known it as Prosperity Spring, the mining hub of Wyoming. Lovely name. But there's nothing nice about chipping away at nature's beauty for some pretty rock. Maybe hard to picture now, but the powers that be didn't always see the value in protecting a place like Golden Ridge. Instead, getting carried along in the gold rush that washed the reserve down the drain. It's hard to say how much damage the toxic metal and acid runoff did to the park. I'm relieved to say that those who could put their foot down before the elks, bears, and whatever Johnson was around got ran out of house and home. Now the town rots where it stands and the gold stays where it should.
Thank you.
you've seen a few of them tumble-down dinosaur bones, you'll have a better idea why the kiddos like them. I still don't.
The locals felt that the regional economy would be unable to thrive if they could not mine Golden Ridge Reserve for its natural resources. They introduced numerous bills to Congress to remove the federal land use restrictions.
You're mowing through these bugs like no tomorrow, Buck. But you still got a quarter left. After that, well, that's when the real fun begins. Clayton out. Hey, Buckaroo, down on the range if you need me. sure about that, sport? You're telling me you seen more of that Bigfoot business? Four down.
Open canyons you could park a plane in means you're far out in Ruby River Range. While you're there, drop by the outpost. Much like any other outpost, you'll be able to find notice boards, storage lockers, a boathouse, and a garage for easy access to transportation. Nathaniel V. Johnson became the first superintendent of the park, however, was denied a salary, funding, and staff. Nathaniel lacked the means to improve the land or properly protect the park, and had few legal methods to enforce such protection. I always kind of knew in the back of my mind I'd end up here. It's nice to get back, to give back, you know?